Sun Temple of Konark, built in the middle of 13th century, is a massive conception of artistic magnificence and engineering dexterity. King Narasimha Dev I, the great ruler of Ganga dynasty, had built this temple with the help of 1200 artisans with a period of 12 years. Konark temple was designed in the form of a gorgeously decorated chariot mounted on 24 wheels, each about 10 feet in diameter and drawn by 7 mighty horses. It is really difficult to understand how this huge temple, where every inch space of which was so wonderfully carved, could have been completed within such a short span of time. Narasimha Dev's desired temple was in the form of a huge rath, means chariot, have 12 pairs of wheels exquisitely carved in the northern and southern sides of the plinth masonry and drawn by a team of 7 spirited horses spreading as if through the heaven. Whatever that might be, Konark temple, even in its present ruined state, still a wonder to the world. Great poet Rabindranath Tagore wrote the Konark, "Here's the language of stone surpasses the language of man." The eastern gateway, which is in the main entrance to the temple compound, is decorated with Gajsimha, means lion upon an elephant, images, with outward faces installed on 2 high stone benches on either sides of the passage. 2 high stone benches are also provided at the inner sides, possibly meant for the guards to sit. Around the base of the temples, there are images of animals, foliage, warriors on the horses, and other interesting structures. The basements of the temple are decorated with a band of about 1,452 elephants in different poses. In some places, the king himself is seen moving the elephant's back, attendants holding the Raja Chakra. Warriors are found proceeding on elephant and horses for a fight, holding swords and shields in their hands. Bears are chased by the hunter in the forest or killed with bow and arrow. The pathetic departing scenes of an old lady going on pilgrimage is most touching. She is seen blessing her own son, while the daughter-in-law bows down to her feet and the grandchild clings to her hand. The middle row of sculptures on the walls is decorated with all sorts of imaginary figures, like lion upon an elephant, lion upon a man, a Nagamithuns with half human and half serpent couples, who fabulously live in deep water in the sea, where they hoard like their treasures. Male and female figures in different poses can also seen in the same row. The next higher row contains a number of bigger sculptures, mostly erotic. The wheels of the chariots are also symbolic and have been interpreted as the wheel of life. They portray the cycle of creation, preservation, and achievement of realization. The diameter of the wheel is about 9 feet, and each of them has a set 8 equal parts. They are elaborately carved all over. The thicker ones are all carved with circular modulation at their centers on the widest part of the face. The axles of the wheel project by about 1 foot from the surface, having similar decorations at their end. The rims are carved with design of foliage with various birds and animals, whereas the modulation in the spokes are carved with the figures of women in various luxurious poses, mostly of erotic nature. These wheels may possibly represent the 12 gods. In the superstructure, sandstone blocks of the most ordinary type were used with closed joints and secured with iron clamps where necessary, while the foundation and the inner core were built with laterite stones. Since the quality of stones used in the superstructures and the motifs were not very durable, they were protected by a thin layer of shell, lime, plaster, and decorated with beautiful and matching colors, which can still be seen in many places. It is evident that the ornamental design and motifs in the wall were carved in a situ, a fitter construction work were over. On the walls and the roof of the temple, beautiful erotic figures are carved. There are three images of sun god positioned to catch the ray of the sun at dawn, noon, and sunset. The Temple of Konar is a masterpiece of Odisha's medieval architecture. The large structure of Konark Temple seen today is actually the entrance of the main temple. The main temple, which enshrined the presiding deity, has fallen off and only the remains can be seen. The figures of elephant, which had originally stood on the side wall of the flights of the steps at the northern and southern side of the Jagmohana, were found amidst the confused mass of debris. They are, however, installed in imaginary platform nearer to the compound walls facing the main temple, but in fact they are to face outwards to welcome people coming in. In the Vedas, Surya is conceived as an unified manifestation of Brahmanical Trinity, the morning sun behind identified with Brahma, the creator, the midday sun with Mahasura, the destroyer, and the evening sun with Vishnu, the preserver. It is probably this conception that the artist had wanted to express in the three images of Surya on the three sides of the Konark Sun temple. The first is Parvatha Surya, means morning sun, the creator. As the plan of the temple slightly makes an angle with the cardinal directions, the image of the south is flooded with the ray of the morning sun, and is therefore significant for its expression of youth and activity. Justifying the description of Parvatha Surya, it is decorated with the typical set of ornaments of the arms, neck, and in the ears. The headdress is also typical. The waistband is provided and with tassels hanging down from it. This is called avanga, means waistband, and it is the Indianized form of aviyogin, the secret waist girdle of the Iranians. The drapery reaching up to the knee is wonderfully carved The hands of the statue holds two full-bloomed lotuses, one of which still exists above the right side of the figures. The bottom of the pedestal is decorated with the figures of women in various poses. Some are playing on musical instrument and some are in dancing poses. It is also decorated with the figures of seven horses driven by Aruna, the charioteer of Surya. Sitting near the feet of the statue, with the reins of the horses in hand, the king and the queen are sitting on the pedestal with folded hands, and the sword is lying nearby. In the panel, two standing figures of male attendants are seen with the shields and swords in their hand. His four wives, Rajani, Rikshukabha, Chhaya, and Surasa, are seen just above the two attendants. Brahma and Vishnu are sitting at the little higher level at the topmost corner of the panel. Vidyadhars are also seen offering garlands of the flower from the heaven. Madhyan Surya means midday sun is expressed as destroyer. The figure is western side may be taken as Madhyan Surya, standing with full vigor and personality. Decoration of the panel, ornaments and drapery used, the presence of king and queen, the seven horses and the figure of Aruna are almost similar to the Prabhat Surya, who also wears Upanath. Some describe the sun with Upanath Pindadabha wearing boots in the both legs. It is stated in the Brihat Samhita that the sun god should be dressed in a fashion of a northerner called Udi Chayavesa. Atschala Surya means evening sun, the preserver. The third figure of the northern Sai wall is Atschala, evening sun or setting sun. The figure brings out beautifully the tired expression which is the result of a hard day's. When all the other horses are completely tired, he is anyhow completing his journey by riding on the back of the last horse, who is also found to be stooping with his folded legs. A simhasan made of chlorite stone and beautifully carved all over is still in existence with the sanctum. Its base and sides are decorated with beaded borders, enclosing rows of elephants and various scenes from day-to-day life, such as women carrying offering, musical instruments and standing in groups. With flooded hand, the king and queen are seen sitting in front. The floor of the room is also powered with the chlorite slabs. Although the presiding deity is now missing from the place, there is no doubt that the image of the sun god actually occupied the simhasan, ruling over the innumerable devotees who worshipped him for about 400 years. With all the pomp and glory which traditionally accompanied the virtual of worships.